today about my ongoing work investigating the role of sexual conflict in the evolution of reinforcement. Traditionally, we think about selection to prevent hybridization as being the same in both sexes. That is, both males and females are selected to avoid costly interspecific matings. But we know within species that male and female interests are not always aligned. And this can also happen between species, giving rise to what I like to call interspecific sexual conflict. This is most likely to occur post-mating. It can happen in animals and plants, but it's easiest to think about in wind-pollinated plants. In this case, once a pollen grain is released into the environment, it has no second chance at reproduction once it's landed on a pistil. Pollen grains that have landed on a heterospecific pistil are better off fertilizing it than fertilizing nothing at all. The pistil, however, would prefer to reject heterospecific pollen in order to avoid costly hybridization and wait for pollen of its own species. In this sense, females are selected to reinforce post-zygotic isolation by evolving isolating barriers, while males are selected to avoid gamete wastage by overcoming these barriers. A great empirical example of this is in maize and its wild relative, Mexicana. When found sympatrically, Mexicana rejects pollination by maize. But there's some maize populations that can overcome the barrier in Mexicana. I modeled the evolution of this pollen pistil incompatibility locus, which is actually two loci. One controls female function, while the other controls male function. Each locus has two alleles. The female functional allele, capital F, acts as a barrier so that pistils carrying it can only be pollinated by pollen with the male functional allele, or the male break allele. Pistils without the barrier can be pollinated by any type of pollen. I use a population genetic model to track the allele frequency of the female barrier and the male break alleles. To address the question, how does sexual conflict affect the evolution of reinforcement? I'm going to briefly describe my model. So I started with two previously allopatric populations that have come into secondary contact. Each generation pollen migrates and fertilizes pistils of either species according to the rules governed by the incompatibility locus. Diploid offspring grow up and undergo selection. I've used a single locus to describe a local adaptation of Mexicana to the Mexican highlands and maize to agricultural fields. Hybrids are intermediate fitness, and so they're not well adapted to either environment. And finally, they undergo meiosis, where recombination only occurs between the incompatibility and the local adaptation locus. So I'm going to walk you through a forward iteration of my model from the perspective of Mexicana, starting where the male break allele is at high frequency and the female barrier is at low frequency. When Mexicana starts exchanging genes with maize, the barrier increases in frequency because females carrying this genotype avoid costly hybridization. Meanwhile, in maize, the break allele has spread from Mexicana and increases in frequency once it's on the maize background. At some point, when the break allele is at high frequency in maize, the barrier allele is no longer effective at preventing hybridization. So overall, we see transient evolution of reinforcement because males that can overcome the barrier have higher fitness than males that cannot. We can track the maximum evolution of reinforcement across a range of selection coefficients. Intuitively, we see that increasing selection strength increases the amount of reinforcement that evolves. And importantly, if we compare this to a pre-mating barrier, we see that there's more reinforcement because males don't have as much incentive to overcome the barrier.